All right, so I just wanted to go over some thoughts, and I'll just kind of let it flow from my brain as I'm sitting here at the computer after finishing the actual PlayStation 4 announcement and watching the video. I actually missed the first few minutes of it, but my understanding is that I didn't miss much. So, all right, so there's a lot of good things to talk about. Basically, the things that kind of caught my interest right off the bat was that it will be able to do save states, meaning you can shut the console off anytime and resume the game you were playing right when you start it up again if you want to. You can actually just stop right where you are. You don't have to do saves or restart levels or whatever. I mean, it depends on if they implement this into every game or whatever, but my understanding is that this might be a console feature that can do it in the UI, but we'll see. I'm wondering if it'll be a solid state drive, actually, in order to do this. Another thing that caught my attention right away with the PlayStation 4 is that it has a dedicated chip solely for doing background tasks, such as downloading updates, downloading continuous content. You'll be able to start playing a game before it's even finished getting onto your console, and it'll keep on streaming in the rest of the game data as you're playing it. Things like that. That's pretty awesome. Another thing that it'll be able to do, from my understanding, and again, this is just from my understanding from watching it, is that supposedly it'll be able to let you, by choice, of course, because you'll be able to decide this and change the options, stream your gaming session. You'll be able to share it with friends only, if you want to do that instead. My understanding is that if you want to, you can open up it up to developers so they can watch you play and actually help you and guide you in the game while you're playing it, if they choose to do so, and if you allow them to do so. You'll also be able to actually record your own gameplay and play it back and upload it to different sections. And yeah, that's pretty awesome. So yeah, the other thing that I thought was weird was that they showed the controller, and apparently they're going to have a light bar similar to what the Wii has and Wii U has. So that was kind of interesting, but they didn't show the console at all, which was really disappointing. I was curious to see that, what the final design was going to be like. They actually indicated that it will have a touchpad on the actual DualShock controller. It's very similar to styles we've seen before. It's a little bit different. But yeah, so there's that. The other thing that was kind of cool is that they showed off some games. Some of them were disappointing, and some of them were pretty cool looking or sounding. The thing with this always is that during these presentations, a lot of times they're pre-rendered. But I think that most of them were actually live demos or rendered in real time, or at least for the videos that they were, in case it was a video. And the biggest disappointment for me was Blizzard. I thought, oh, cool, Blizzard is going to actually have something on the consoles. All they're doing is porting Diablo 3, so that's really disappointing. Watch Dogs looked really interesting. Looked like you could do some really cool stuff. You could actually tap into different electronic systems in the city. If you think of Grand Theft Auto, only with not really in the same gameplay style, but you know, kind of the open world. But then you can hack into the train station to control the train itself, or police barriers would pop up out of the ground in the video that they showed upon your command in order to stop the police from chasing you. Things like that. It was interesting. That looked really cool, and it was really gorgeous if that was running in real time. That was very impressive graphically to me. There's some interesting games actually coming out from the creator Braid, and they got some stuff from even David Perry. He actually used to make Earthworm Jim and a game that I used to like a lot called Sacrifice that a lot of people don't remember. That was pretty awesome. They're actually behind this technology where you'll be able to do everything on the fly with the PlayStation. They'll be able to do all the stuff I mentioned with streaming and downloading in the background and stuff. One thing that kind of wasn't interesting to me was that they're going to be advertising games to you that will download in the background based on your trends. So that if you are seen as playing a certain genre, like fighting games, for example, they may download fighting games to the console that you haven't purchased yet, just simply offering it to you so that it's readily available in case you wanted to buy it or try it. Now, I don't know how that's going to be handled, but if they do it right, it might be cool. If they don't, then it could be intrusive. I think I kind of like the fact that they might actually advertise based on trends. That's the one thing that honestly comes up all the time when it comes to advertising, is that people don't mind it if it's targeted to their likes, their interests. And I agree. I want to hear about new stuff that I might think is cool, but only what I think is cool, you know? And we'll see how that works. But yeah, tomorrow they're going to be actually updating PlanetSide from what I understand, and the new SMGs will be actually coming out. They had the first batch of the SMGs, the submachine guns, come out, and they were a big hit. At least I liked mine for the Vanu, and I don't know much about the new ones yet, but I'll check it out and maybe even put a video on it. We'll see. But I wanted to go ahead and just talk about the Sony event, and it is pretty interesting. I like some of that stuff. And the thing is that I own the PlayStation 1 and 2, and I didn't get 3. I just had this feeling that the Microsoft team was going to do something better, and I was right in most respects. And I know some Sony fans might get pissed at me about that, but I'm being honest here. If you ask me, if we don't look at worldwide sales and just those numbers, I think that the Xbox 360 actually kicked the crap out of a lot of expectations. And it's not just me justifying a purchase. I'm being completely honest. I think they did an excellent, excellent job. And Sony had to catch up in a lot of ways. And Nintendo actually made a mess of it. They had an interesting concept and just dropped the ball on everything else, from what I've seen. I have a Wii. It actually took me a long time to get it when it was brand new. I had to actually go at midnight and sit there for 6 hours in the wee morning hoping to get one a few times, and I vowed I'd never do that again. So yeah, I just wanted to kind of rumble and rant about this conference that they just had from Sony and show some PlanetSide footage that I randomly threw together just for something interesting to watch. And yeah, leave me some comments actually as to what you think about all of this. I'm really curious to see what Microsoft is going to do in response. And I'm interested also in seeing more details. What's the pricing going to be? What are the specs going to be? My understanding is that's going to have quite a bit of RAM, and it's going to be really fast RAM, shared RAM. And the CPU and GPU are going to be, you know, bundled together on the same die, unless I misunderstood that. I'm assuming that AMD might be involved because of that, because they're leaning in that direction most of the time. Intel has been a little bit, but you know, it'd be more comparable if Nvidia got involved, but they're not, obviously. We'll see. We'll see how this goes. New Nvidia drivers actually came out yesterday, I think it was, too, so check that out in case you haven't. And thanks again for listening to me rant and stuff, and again, let me know what you think about the new console.